every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to.
Well, grace and peace, and good morning to each and every one of you. Welcome to Fresh Start. My wife makes fun of me when I say, this is Pastor Daryl Fair, and I'm excited to bring you into a brand new day or step into this brand new day with you. And the Bible tells us very plainly in Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse number 23, that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is his faithfulness to you and I. Every day we wake up, every day we know that we are alive, every day that we know that we are above ground and not beneath, we know that God has brought us into a brand new day. And indeed, God has given us a fresh start, which is inclusive of grace and mercy. We've been talking about prayer, of course, and we've pivoted from talking about what to do in the meantime. And now we're just talking about fresh perspectives on prayer. And while we are getting ready to move into today's perspective on prayer, I want to invite you back to Luke chapter number 11. And while you are getting your Bible together, for those of you who have never subscribed to this channel, go ahead and do that so that you don't miss anything, any of the content that God intends for this ministry to supply you. And so when you subscribe, you'll be able to notified of everything that we post that is for public consumption so that it can be a blessing to you. So if you have not subscribed, go ahead and do that even now. I want to go to Luke chapter number 11, verse number two, and the Bible says, and he said unto them, when ye pray, say, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Yesterday, we talked about the fact that he is our Father. Today's perspective on prayer is a little different than yesterday's in that, yes, he is our Father. Yes, we can pray to him as if we know him, and we should. But we should also be aware of the fact that he is holy and his name is holy. Let me put this on the screen. When the scripture says, hallowed be thy name, not only is he holy, but his name is holy. Yes, he is our God, but his name is holy. If you notice in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, you will see that the word God or the title God is not spelled out. There's a gap that's there. You'll also discover that the YHWH, which is a shortened transliteration of Yahweh. And then you see a blank space down there at the bottom. Each one of these notations at the bottom left-hand corner of the screen is used to highlight the fact that God's name was holy, or is holy, I should say. In scripture and in history, the Hebrews were so taken by God that his very name was holy to them because he said so, but they treated his name as such. In other words, when they were writing and they needed to write out his name, some scholars suggest that they would never really write out his entire name. And in our modern day, sometimes you'll find people who will write God, but they will write it the way that I wrote it, G space D. That is a nod to the fact that he is holy and his name is holy. Again, the transliteration in the English of Yahweh, you'll find the YHWH, because again, they didn't feel even comfortable writing out his entire name as they would write out any other name. So to put him in a different category, they wouldn't even write out his full name. Not only that, but there are times, history suggests, that when the writers were writing and they were referencing God, in some cases, they would just leave a space there because his name was so holy, his title was so holy, that they did not want to treat him like anything else. I said all of that to say this, our fresh focus and our perspective on prayer for this morning is simply this, that yes, he's our Father, and yes, we can pray to him as if we know him. But one of the other things that we need to be mindful of is the fact that this God that we serve and that we worship, he is not like anyone else on the planet, in the universe. He's not like our mother. He's not like our father. He's not like our spouses. He's not like our children. He's different. One of the definitions of the word holy, I think it's the Hebrew word hagios, which means other than. God is other. He's not like anyone else. He is other than. So though we have proximity to talk to God, and though we have this connection to be able to talk to God in prayer, let us never forget, let us never forget and never become so common in our prayer time that we forget the fact that he is God. Hallelujah. Listen, that's all the time that I have for you this morning. As you pray, pray like you know him. Talk to him like you know him. However, respect him because he is God. Listen, whatever you're facing today, just know you're not facing it by yourself. God has brought you into a brand new day. You've outlived some things on yesterday. God has brought you into this brand new day, but you're not here by yourself. He, that is God, is walking with you. Accept that truth today as you begin this brand new day. God bless you. I will see you in the morning. God bless. This is the gospel. This is the good news.